Marp lets you create beautiful presentations from your text editor with Markdown. It's fast and easy. In this video, I'm going to show you how. The easiest way of using Marp is as a VS Code extension. To install it, go to the Extensions panel. In the search bar, enter Marp and install Marp for VS Code. Let's create a presentation. At the top of a new file, let's put three dashes, Marp, colon, true, and another three dashes. And we get a blank slide, progress. If you don't see anything, make sure to click the Open Preview button here. Let's add some content. Marp is basically just common Mark Markdown. So, we can use Markdown syntax to create headers and bulleted lists. This is a good start, but it looks a little plain. Let's make it look better. We can switch between the three included themes by using the theme directive at the top of the document. There are three built-in themes: default, uncover, and Gaia. If you want to switch to a dark mode version of a theme, we can also add the class invert directive. I like the inverted uncover theme, so let's go with that for now. As a data scientist, I talk about code a lot. Using triple backticks as delimiters, we can create a code block. That looks all right, but we can make it better. By specifying our code's language after the first triple backtick, Marp will use highlight.js to syntax highlight our code block. When I'm not talking about code, I'm probably talking about math. To enable math typesetting in Marp, we can add the math directive to our document and set it to either Kotek or MathJax. Then, we can write single-line math expressions using a dollar sign as a delimiter, or multi-line expressions using $2 signs. We can use Markdown syntax to include images in our presentations. There are a whole slew of options that can be used to size, place, and modify images. You can find all the details at this link. I'll include that link in the description. Here are just a few examples. Suppose you want to make a content slide with an image on one side of the slide and a bulleted list on the other. How would you do that in Marp? We can try including an image, then writing a bulleted list, and that doesn't work. The right way to do this is to use the background or BG argument and a directional argument like left when including our image. Here, we use BG to put our image in the background and left to put our image on the left-hand side of the slide. Then, when we add our bulleted list again, we can get our text on one side and our image on the other. Awesome. What if we want an impactful slide with a huge single word? How would you do that in Marp? We can use the fit directive to stretch our header to the extents of the slide. But what if that's not enough? To maximize the impactfulness of my big, bold slide, I want to use a different background and font color. We can use spot directives to change our style on just this slide. Here, we set the background color to black and our font color to red. Previously, we made a two-column slide with an image on one side and text on the other. It should be easy to make two columns of text, right? Right? Unfortunately, no. But it is possible. Let me show you. First, we'll need to enable custom CSS in the Marp plugin settings. After, at the top of our document, let's add some custom styling. Full transparency, I yoinked this snippet straight from the Marp GitHub, and I recommend you do the same. I'll put a link in the description. Let's use our custom style. If we make a div with class equal columns that contains two subdivs, we can write two columns of text. And done. Two columns. I do wish this was a bit easier, but hey, at least it's possible. There are a few other things worth mentioning. Since we've already enabled custom HTML, we can use spans to style individual words and sections. Further, Marp supports emojis, so if we want to make our title a bit more snazzy, we can add a rocket to our title. Until now, we've focused on creating slides, but how do we present them? Marp makes it easy to export to a variety of file formats, including HTML, PDF, PowerPoint, PNG, and JPEG. Let's start with HTML because it supports the most features. This gives us a single HTML file that we can open in our browser. When opened, we see a toolbar at the bottom of the page. This shows us our progress through the slides and gives us the option to open the presentation in full screen mode or in presenter view. To step through the slides, we can click the arrow buttons on the toolbar or use our keyboard's arrow keys. When we get to our bulleted list, you'll notice that each item appears one at a time. This is because we used asterisks when writing our itemized list rather than dashes. Marp calls these fragmented lists. If instead we want all of the bullets to appear simultaneously, we could have used dashes. Marp also supports PDF, but compared to HTML, it's missing a few features. Things like fragmented lists won't work, and some styling may not look quite right. For example, on my laptop, the shadows around code blocks rendered as a solid color, rather than a gradient. All in all, PDF is totally usable. PowerPoint also works pretty well, but is a little weird. When rendered, everything looks great, until you realize that your slides are effectively a series of non-editable static images. To its credit, the content looks accurate. For example, the code block shadow is a gradient. And I suppose you could add additional content on top of your slides or add transition animations between your slides using this approach. The PNG and JPEG export modes are mostly useless, as they only render the first slide. Just use one of the other file formats.